Beginning in the mid-19th century and continuing into the 20th, a new kind of graphic blossomed across America: large-scale outdoor advertising. In early America, shops announced themselves with decorated windows or a sign over the door, but large, flat-sided commercial or private structures offered a new canvas, an enticement to create distinctive, colorful signs painted on building walls or roofs, or even natural features. Painted with care and stylistic flair by lettering artists who earned the nickname Wall Dogs, these signs boomed the products and enterprises of a growing, diversifying American economy. Bright colors, logos, and trademark promotional phrases made an impression on the consumer. Urban buildings and hamlets and cities alike, rural barns, and even rock outcrops were pressed into the service of this new art. With the spread of billboards and other advertising media, the vogue for wall signs faded. Many were obscured as new buildings went up, others were covered over with paint or plaster, or were simply left to fade away, long after what or who they advertised closed their doors. The Wall Dogs did good work, though. Across Arkansas and the nation, these graphics, many created using tenacious lead-based paint, survive as ghost signs, persistent reminders of our business past. In the 1990s, the Arkansas Historic Preservation Program, a division of the Department of Arkansas Heritage, began documenting Arkansas's ghost signs. This project led to Ghost Signs of Arkansas, Off-the-Wall Relics, an exhibit which made its debut at the Old State House in 1994. The exhibit featured photographs by Jeff Holder and text by Cynthia Haas. The images recorded fading wall signage from Truman, Fordyce, Conway, Pine Bluff, Prescott, and other towns across the state. Many of the signs had outlasted the products they publicized. The exhibit graced the offices of the Arkansas Senate for many years, then went into storage. This summer, however, Capitol visitors will be able to enjoy these ghosts once more. Ghost Signs of Arkansas is on view in the Capitol's lower level gallery through August. The images are more than two decades old, and the survival rate of the signs depicted is unknown, so for this outing, the exhibit is doubly ghostly. The signs recorded were shades of their original selves, while Jeff Holder's images preserve in virtual form the shades of things that have long since disappeared altogether.